Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kenzie. Some of you would know me as Kenzie's Collection from Instagram. Today I filmed a first impression on the Maybelline Superstay Foundation. If you want to see what I think, just keep watching. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe while you're here. So today I'm gonna do a first impressions of the Maybelline Superstay Foundation. I took a wild guess and I think this is my color, but I'm not sure, so this could be funny. I don't really use primers of any type. I just like to moisturize my face. So today I'm just gonna put a little bit of the Drunk Elephant Bee Hydra on my face. And I'll just do that. Yeah, so this could be fun because I don't know if this is gonna be my shade or not. I really hope it is because I have to go to work. Like straight after this. All right. I'm already excited because this has a pump and 97%. Do any of the Maybelline foundations have pumps? I don't think so, but this does and that makes me happy. Just gonna do maybe like this much on my hand. I'm just gonna use a flat top kabuki brush. This one's from a brand called Holy Grail Cosmetics, which is an Australian brand. And I'm just gonna buff that. Okay, so far this color seems like, is it a good match? I think it'll be a good match. I'm gonna get my lip now. Yeah, I think this is a good match for me. It seems to be really full coverage. Like you can see I have quite rosy cheeks, but on this one that's kind of just gone. Blend my ears, down my neck. All right, is the lighting funny today? You can see it's like not quite, it's probably a bit pink for me actually. But I can make that work. I need more. So I've just done another 3 pumps. This is why I never do my brows first, because I always end up getting foundation on them and then it's nobody wants foundation brows, so I just do them like a boss now. But I always do my eyes first, which is like a weird, I don't know. Alright, this is really full coverage. This looks really beautiful, actually. It seems to have set really quite quickly. I hope those crease lines don't hang around. Okay. Actually pretty happy with the way this is buffed in. I usually use my Exo Beauty Flawless Finish sponge and just kind of like do any last blending, because you know sometimes when you use a brush, like, it's a bit streaky. So I'm just gonna lightly go over the foundation with my sponge and just really make sure everything's blended in. Actually, if I didn't have these weird tan lines from my sports bras, I think this is a pretty good color match for me, which I'm really happy about because I took a wild guess and this is what we got. All right, I'm just gonna use the Tarte Shape Tape now as my concealer. And I wanna see how that blends over the top because this is my number one concealer. It looks really light compared to this foundation. That's okay. So I really like how this foundation is sitting on my face right now, and I think that that concealer buffed in really well. So I'm really happy so far with it. I'm not gonna say it's my holy grail yet because it's been on my face like a minute and a half, like maybe not even that. But yeah, I think it looks really good. Now, I'm just gonna continue with my everyday like face routine, and that means the Too Faced Ethereal Setting Powder is up next, and I'm just gonna kind of speed through the rest of this because all we really wanted to see is the foundation, right? Okay, so after using my setting powder on this foundation, you can't really tell like in the video, but when I look in the mirror, I'm very orange. Like I'm very orange. I will try to take a photo to show you what I mean. Like you can see. Yeah, look at this. Okay, so this is where I stopped blending. And look at like the difference. Can you see? Yeah, you can see. So, this might not be the right shade. This is definitely oxidized a bit. But I think it's a really nice finish so far. I'm gonna finish my makeup now. All right, here's my look for the day. I'm gonna go to work now. I'll try to do a check-in if I can, mid-wear. If not, I'll do one before I head to bed tonight and let you know what I think. So I've just stepped outside to take a few photos for my Instagram, and I think this foundation looks so beautiful. Like you guys saw, I didn't really put a primer on, so I don't think my pores look too bad, and I think this is a really beautiful foundation. It's just a shame that like the color that I got is so different. Can you see? Like it's so different to my natural. This lighting's not like letting me show you. I'm at work, but I'm gonna do a quick check-in. It's been about 7 hours and I'm actually pretty happy with the like foundation itself. It's gotten a little glowy, but that's because I didn't use any primer or setting spray. I'll check back in later. Alright guys, so I've just gotten home, and as you can see, this foundation has not treated me well. I will admit, it has been a very hot night, and I've been at work, so I'm like a bit Sweaty. But yeah. And also, it's actually been like, I would put this on at 2 o'clock and it's 11 now. So what's that, 10 hours? And I haven't blotted it and I haven't put any extra powder on it. And I didn't use the setting spray because I wanted to really see how long back on how well it would last. I wanted to do more check-ins, but because of work, like, I couldn't really do them. Yeah. But yeah, we'll just, so you can really, like, see. I don't know, like, here, it's kind of gone. And, like, because of my sweat, my mascara has just, like, melted into my under eyes. Does anyone know how to stop that? Because that happens to me all the time. What else? I'm looking over here because the viewfinder. Damn girl, what highlight you use? My sweat. But yeah, you can see. This is not me wanting glowy skin. I'm gonna have to test it out again and see if it does like a... like for a shorter period of time, like not when I'm not at work, and just see kind of like how it grows. But like this color is not right for me. It's not gonna, hang on. You, I don't know if you can tell because of how shiny I am. Oh, look at all that excess oil. It's like a highlighter. Yeah. I don't know. I liked this foundation to start with. I just don't think it's a long wear foundation for me, especially during like hot summery nights. But yeah. I don't know. What do you think? Thanks so much for watching.